Hi, you guys. So I am just here going to talk a little bit about, update for the year and what's going on and what potentially could be going on or will be going on or blah, 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 whatever, whatever. So basically, I'll start out with you guys. If you have been following me, you know that I've been doing the 21-day fix. I started right after I got back from my summer vacation back in June. And I ended my first round of 21-day fix on the 4th of July, no, I'm sorry, July 26th, around July 26th, which is my daughter's birthday. It was like the last day, so we cut it, the first round off by one day. 21-day fix was awesome. I lost 10 pounds. I didn't lose 10 pounds in the first 21 days. I did 21-day fix for four rounds. So you work out every single day. You don't take a break. Every single day. Towards the last round, we started taking a break like one day a week because, you know, to work out every day, it's not that easy. You're taking out, it's only 30 minutes when you're doing your workout, but, you know, things got really hectic towards the holidays. It was October. We have a big thing over here in October. We do like a whole block shut down and do like a haunted house and everything with a couple of our neighbors. So and then moving on out of October was November, starting in with Thanksgiving and getting ready for Christmas and holidays and shopping and this and that. So our workouts were getting sporadic. So I say our because I work out with my sister-in-law. So they were getting sporadic, and then it started being, you know, missing one day, and then it was 2 days a week, and then it was just like, oh, I don't have time, I need to run here, I need to run there, I need to do that. The kids were out of school and I had to run here and there. It was just hectic, lots of things going on. So sadly to say, although I was still working out, but it was very sporadic, so I would consider myself on a break for a couple of months, even though I was working out here and there. But anyway, so we started again on Sunday, this past Sunday, and doing the 21-day fix. I did order, however, something new that I want to go ahead and try out. Did I say that I lost? Yeah, I did say how much I lost. So the 21-day fix, let me finish off with that. It has an eating plan, which is super simple to follow. You can, once you learn how to use the little containers that it has, you can learn how to modify your meals of how you like to eat, what you like to eat, based on the little portion control thing. And let me tell you, I've said this before, when you get those little containers from 21 Day Fix, you look at them and you wanna cry because you're just like, that's all I'm gonna eat, I'm gonna starve. Yeah, it's like that. So, but it's really not so, because there is so much food. There really is a lot of food. And if you feel like it's not enough and you need to eat a little bit more, add a little bit more vegetables to your meal. I'm okay with vegetables. I know a lot of people don't like it. I eat a lot of spinach and I think it's called the California mix. I didn't buy all fresh vegetables all the time. I got, you know, frozen vegetables because, face it, vegetables, they go rancid pretty quickly and they're not always the freshest from the grocery store. So when I would stir fry foods, frozen is fine for me. Anyway, so the food is the biggest thing. It's really, really important to follow that diet, or to learn how to portion out your foods properly. But anyway, I decided I wanted to go ahead and do something different because the 21-day fix was kind of getting a little bit old. Although I was like, I want to do something different, but I didn't want to do something really, really hard. Like 21-day fix, they have a new one out and it's like 21-day fix extreme or something like that. I don't know, I just want to stay healthy and fit. I just don't want to push my body to the limits anymore. I did CrossFit for a few years and my body was like screaming for help, like, just stop, you're in pain, quit it. I mean, my shoulder was really bad. My shoulder's awesome now. I don't have any pains, I don't have anything with my shoulder anymore. And my hips were hurting all the time before when I was in CrossFit. I did a lot of heavy weight lifting in CrossFit. I could lift pretty significant weight. So since I'm not lifting as much as I have been, you know, that as well made my body shrink a little bit as well. But anyway, so moving on to the new program, I have Insanity Max 30 here. I'm super excited. So I guess you can say this is like kind of like an unboxing of the Insanity Max 30. So when you get it, you open the box, it comes like this. This came separately outside of the box. Let me just show you. It came in a big box like this from Beachbody. And I chose the challenge pack. So inside the challenge pack, you get obviously this one here. And let me get into what's in here. I haven't even opened it. So I'll do, we'll go ahead and open everything that's in here because everything is still sealed up in the package. All right, so inside the plastic here, it just has some pamphlets in here. This one says, want a free Insanity Max 30. I maxed out t-shirt, so with the 21 day fix, I did get that t-shirt after completing my first 21 days. So you're supposed to take your before and after pictures, and I'll end up doing all of that. It gives you a guide of how to do your pictures and all that stuff. Get max results with Shakeology is next here. So the challenge pack does come with a Shakeology. You get to choose what kind you want. I do want to recommend to you that if you get anything from Beachbody or any Shakeology or anything like that, if you only want to get one, make sure you call them and tell them that you don't want any more to be delivered, because they will send them out automatically. Even if you choose, I didn't see that option this time around, but last time I chose only a one-time delivery and they still shipped it out. And they were like, oh, that's just the way it is. And I'm like, but that's not what the option I chose, and whatever. So yeah, Shakeology. I have to say Shakeology is pretty freaking awesome. And I think when I started to take Shakeology, I was doing 21 day fix only. And then 2 months into it, I think 2 months or something, maybe 3 months into it, I started to take the Shakeology and more weight just came flying right off. It was, I don't know what it is about Shakeology. It was really good. So, and it doesn't taste bad. I got vanilla. This is my third bag of Shakeology. It's inside the box. I'll show you in a second. So it comes with this little book, Getting Started. So I guess this is just telling you how you do workouts and things like that. I'll have to take a look into this, how to track your time. So I've seen that when you max out, like they have something like your goal is to go through the whole 30 minutes. And when you max out, meaning you just can't do anymore, you stop, you write down your time, and then you go on, take a little break, and then you continue on for the rest of the workout. So, oh, cool. Okay, so they have a little weight tracker right here, and measurement tracker. You take your photo, and then you write your measurements for day 1, day 30, day 60. So I will be using that as well. Awesome. So here is the calendar. So this is the calendar of what you're supposed to follow. And then when you max out, you write down your max out time here. How many minutes and how many seconds that you've done. And on the screen, it tells you your minutes and seconds, so you don't have to worry about getting like a stopwatch or something like that. So awesome, that's excellent. I was wondering where I was gonna be writing down my max out time. So, and they have the first month is one set of videos, and then the second month is another set of videos. So that's what that looks like right there. And the rest is just some information there. Next, they have a little food guide, I guess you can go by. It just says no time to cook guide. Tips for eating out. It kind of tells you different foods that you can try to eat versus, like if you're gonna go to a Chinese restaurant, for instance, is Chinese, try this, skip that. Oh, okay, so instead of having egg rolls, it says to have steamed dumplings instead. So it tells you some different options that you can choose when you go out to eat, which that's pretty awesome. So instead of refried beans, get pinto or black beans. Okay, oh, cool, so it's like for every cuisine. Excellent. Okay, fast food do's and don'ts, different tips like that. Oh, even going to the grocery store, and there's calorie intakes for different things. This is excellent. I really, really like that. I'm glad that he put that in this book. So even Wendy's, Subway, different foods that are the best choices, frozen meals even. What? Excellent. It tells you how to read the nutrition guide here, like what you should be looking into. So excellent with that as well. The different types of healthy frozen foods, which ones are the best? Awesome. All right, the max out calendar. Yikes. All right, so I can month one, month two. You have the calendars where you can write out your max out. And I don't know what the difference is between the different sides. Follow this calendar if you seriously want Shanti's six-pack abs and are willing to spend a bit more time to make it happen. We're talking 10 to 15 minutes. Oh, okay. So this is the videos itself, and this is the extras. Like, I guess they have 10, 15 minute extras in the videos. I don't really know. So they have the back side and the front side, so you can track your stuff that you're going to be doing there. I have to look into that because I don't even know. And then they have the nutrition to the max. Wow, this is a pretty thick book, and it's a pretty good size. The 21 day fix book was like this big right here. That's it. It was really small. I was told that this Insanity Max 30 follows the 21 day fix. Like if you're used to the 21 day fix, that you would do better with this. So I chose to go ahead and get this one versus the T25 because I was told that this flows right into from the 21 day fix easier. I would have a lot easier time, you know, with the nutrition and all that. The T25, they advertise 5 ingredients in your meals. So only 5 ingredients scares me because I like a lot of stuff. I mean, I don't know. I don't know what it entails, honestly, the T25. But also the T25, even though it's only 25 minutes a day, on Fridays you double up. So it's like about an hour on Fridays and you don't work out on the weekends. And I believe this is how, yeah, on Saturday and Sunday you don't have to work out for the max 30 either. So this book here, let's see, it just has the 3 steps to get started, the food directory, beverages, recipes, Shakeology smoothie bar, the do-it-yourself for omelets, salad, dinner plates, sample meal plans, how and when to add or subtract foods, and frequently asked questions. So already it looks like these were like the Shakeology containers here. They look exactly the same as what I already have in my kitchen. And then this is the chart that you're supposed to follow. So for me, I'm pretty sure this one is really simple. The 21 day fix gave you like a calculation that you would have to, you know, you calculate your weight with the this and the that and your height or something like that. I don't know how it worked. I forget. But this one is really simple. It just says if you're 150 pounds, you follow this chart, and if you're over, you follow this chart over here. So that's exciting. So it tells you all the veggies that you should have, different carbs, and each one of these containers, each one of these containers is the same as, let's say, the red is protein, the orange is fats and nuts, and then the blue is cheeses, the purple is fruit, and the green is vegetables, and the yellow down there is carbs. So this kind of tells you like what, see, like yellow is carbs here, it tells you which carbs that you should be eating, different substitutions, like if you want to have milk or something, you could substitute one of these carbs here, one of these beverages for a carb. That's pretty freaking cool. Tells you different things that you should avoid. Soda and juice. Oh my gosh. That's a big one. You know, as soon as you stop drinking soda, everything just sucks in and your cellulite goes away. Different recipes. So they have some pretty decent recipes in here. They look really good. Carb recipes, that's excellent. How to make them and Oh, nice recipes for different cards. They look yummy. You see that? Doesn't that look good? Great pictures. You don't expect this out of a workout video to give you such excellent recipes. Different seasoning mixes that you can use, salad dressings, and then Shakeology recipes. I usually just have my Shakeology with just nothing. Lately, I've been adding some fruit. Okay, so. And then the other thing, the last thing that's in the box are the videos. Let me open up the videos. So they have the blue is month one. So they're all the videos here for month one. And then month two is in red. So month one is here, and then month two, you flip it over, and then this is month two. All right, so each one of these videos, it has the regular standard video, and then they have like the bonus, the ab attack 10 for 10 minutes. So I guess not all of them have it. This one has one. So I can't wait. I'm so excited to do this. And then they have the additional video here, which I don't know what this one is. Let me open this one up. It just says dig. Deep Live with Shanti Sweat Fest. I don't know what this is. Oh, 30 minutes of old school insanity. Join Shanti and actual customers in a live workout that is totally insane for 30 minutes. Also, it's just an additional workout from Insanity. I've done Insanity. It is completely insane. Okay, so what else besides that was inside the box? If you're just going to be getting the Insanity Max 30, that's what's going to be inside the box minus this one. So you get all those guides, nutrition plans, and the books and the videos. Now for the challenge pack, you get this is the 3-day refresh. I've known a few people that have done the 3-day refresh. One girl I know that she lost 6 pounds in 3 days. It's just to kickstart your workout, your cleanse out your body and everything. And you can actually eat some foods. It's only fruits and vegetables, I believe. Fruits, vegetables, and healthy fats. And then you drink these shakes. But it's super expensive. If I'm not mistaken, I could be wrong. I don't know. I want to say that it's in the $200 range for that 3-day refresh. Yikes. And then here is the Beachbody Challenge. These are different challenges that you can do. You see, they have the T25, the P90X3, the 21 Day Fix, and just some info here. This one, what you love. Oh, because I got the Shakeology, I guess. This is just a little bit about Shakeology, where it comes from, and whatever else is in here. I don't even know what's in here. And then how much my whatever you want to call that. And then I got the vanilla Shakeology. So this is enough Shakeology for 30 shakes. So 30 days, 30 shakes. You drink one shake a day. And when you're following the 21 Day Fix meal plan, this is not in place of, this is considered as one protein. So if you're allotted 3 proteins or 6 proteins or whatever, how many proteins it is that you're allotted for your weight bracket, then you use this in place of a protein. So it's pretty good because if you want breakfast and you want protein and you want a carb and you want some fruit, you can have that and mix it in together or have that on the side and eat some toast or something like that. So it's just not like you have that instead. Or you can have that as a snack midday or something like that. And it's pretty good. It's not that bad. So that is my Insanity Max 30. I'm super excited. Are you excited? I can't wait to start doing it. This is a 60-day plan. So it's 60 days and it's 5 days a week. Not too bad. 21 Day Fix was every single day, 30 minutes a day, and then you can do an additional. You're supposed to double up on, I forget which, is it the second week or the third week? I don't remember. I think it's the third week that you double up. I can't remember. because I honestly, I never did do the double up on the 21 day fix. I just didn't have time. It's an hour a day. I didn't have time to do that double up. So that's why my results weren't so extravagant for the 21 day fix, because I did not do the double ups. But this one, 30 minutes a day, 5 days a week. You can do the additional 10 minute ab series, different ab series, I guess, that they have here. And I'm super excited to get started. Yes, 30 minutes, not too bad. 5 days a week, not too bad. So thank you for watching. You can follow me along in my journey. I guess I'll do vlog updates as I go along with my Max 30. I'm not exactly sure when I'm gonna start it, if I'm gonna start it this week or I'm gonna start it maybe next week. But you will find out when I do start, because I will be talking about it. So thank you guys so much. If you have any questions or comments, or if you've done the Max 30 before, let me know. What do you think? How is it compared to any other programs? Maybe if you've done the 21 day fix before, or you've done any other programs before, let me know how this compares and what you think about it. I would very much want to know, like to know. I know that I will find out very soon, but yeah, let me know. I'm very curious. All right, guys, I'll see you in another video.